Hey guys, welcome back to electronicsinnovation.com. In this video, we are going to see how to send an email alert based on the threshold temperature and update the both recipient email address and temperature threshold wirelessly. If the temperature is above or below the threshold, this ESP32 will send an alert email to the programmed recipient email as shown here. So, without wasting time, let's get started. Required components are ESP32 module, DS18B20 temperature sensor, 4.7 kilo-ohm pull-up resistor, breadboard, and some connecting wires. If we look at the overview of this tutorial, it has 4 steps. First one is getting email account ready. Second one is installing the required libraries and programming part. Third one is circuit diagram and connections on breadboard. And the final one is testing and debugging as usual. So let's move to the first step, getting Gmail account ready. I recommend creating a new email account to send the emails to your recipient address. Do not use your official one to send emails via ESP32. If some malfunction happened or something goes wrong in your code, or if by mistake you make too many requests, your account can be banned or have your account temporarily disabled. For the recipient mail, you can use the official one. There will be no issue. Open your favorite browser and create a new email account for sending emails with ESP32 by filling all the required details as shown here. Log into the Gmail account and allow less secure apps from the security tab to get access to this new Gmail account as shown here. Google will send an security alert for this. Don't be panic, just ignore this mail. Let's move to the second step, installing the required libraries and programming part. This code will be available on the project page, which is mentioned in the description below. We will program the ESP32 using arduinoIDE. So make sure that you have ESP32 add-on installed in your arduinoIDE. If you don't have it, just follow the above tutorial to install it. These are the libraries we are using here. We will use ESP32 mail client library to send emails and ESP32 async web server, async TCP libraries to build asynchronous web server. Go to the following directory as shown here and click on the manage libraries. The library manage will open. Search for the ESP32 mail client by Mobjit and install the library as shown here. Coming to these two libraries, these are not available to install through the Arduino Library Manager. So you need to add them manually by downloading from the GitHub. Visit the GitHub page using the links mentioned in the project page and download the zip files as shown here and save them into the known directory. To install the library, go to the following directory and click on the add zip library and select the libraries you have just downloaded. After adding libraries, a status message will show here. Repeat the same process for other also. Provide the credentials such as SSID and password of the available Wi-Fi network which has an internet connection. Enter the freshly created sender email address and password here. Enter the SMTP server settings of the sender email right here. You can find the SMTP settings of different mail server on the right side. I am using Gmail, so I have entered the same Gmail SMTP settings here. Enter the default recipient email address and default threshold for the temperature here. Anyway, you can change them later also. Now the code is ready to upload. It's time to go to the third part, circuit diagram and connections. Connect the circuit as shown here. Let me connect my circuit for demonstration. So, I have connected 3.3 ground and GPIO4 of ESP32 with VCC, ground and data pins of the sensor respectively. Connect the micro USB cable with ESP32 and connect the another end of the cable to your PC. Come back to Arduino IDE, go to Tools, check the uploading configurations such as ESP32 demo module, uploading speed, and make sure that you have selected the right port. If everything is okay, then click on the uploading button. When the log shows like this, hold the boot button of ESP32 as shown here. As soon as the writing started, release the button. After successful uploading, open the serial monitor. Here, you can find the ESP IP address to access the web server where you can see the current temperature and update the temperature threshold and recipient email address. Here, you can also see the current temperature and some logs about the email communication for debugging. Open your favorite browser, key in the ESP IP address and click on the enter button. A similar web page should load with the default values. If you change the temperature threshold and click on the submit button, the same thing will be replicated on the device side as shown here. Let's try with the threshold below the current temperature. Same thing is repeated. If the temperature is below or above the threshold, a mail with appropriate mail body content will be sent to the recipient mail. Let's check the mail. Here you can see I have received two new mails. First one is saying that the temperature is above the threshold and second one is saying that temperature is below threshold. Because we have updated the temperature threshold two times with a different threshold as above and below the current temperature. Let's try the same thing in the mobile also. Let me enter the ESP32 IP address. Similar to the previous web page has loaded here. Let me change the threshold to 30 and submit. As soon as I submit, I got a new mail notification here from ESP32. Let's open it. It is showing the temperature is above the threshold. The current temperature is 34.13 degrees Celsius. Let's update the temperature threshold 35 degrees Celsius. I got a new mail which is showing that the temperature is below threshold and the current temperature is 34.19 degrees Celsius. Likewise, we can send email alert based on the threshold temperature and update both email address and temperature threshold wirelessly. If the temperature is above or below the threshold, this ESP32 will send an appropriate email alert to the programmed recipient mail.